Sometimes, to move forward properly, you have to take a backward glance. Let's do that now. Do you remember Sunny and Pompon from episode 1? Let me tell you a bit more about their story. Sunny is actually the real name of this cat. Before his superposition in the macroscopic world, he was almost raised as a normal cat, but he was far from a normal cat simply by the fact that Sunny was my son. I made sure he had a proper childhood, but did not neglect to give him proper training. I put him in superposition very early in his life, and it was the smoothest superposition I ever witnessed, so I began to have great plans for him. Unfortunately, Sunny felt he was so special and rapidly orchestrated his own plans behind my back. To protect the quantum plan, I had to make the biggest sacrifice of my life. I got rid of Sunny by putting a renal insufficiency in his genetic code. Before being born, before betraying me, he was condemned. Sunny died age 7. Am I a monster to have killed my own beloved son? I assure you, that is not the question you should ask yourself. How could I give Sunny this disease if the macroscopic world is a block universe where everything is already written? That, on the other hand, would be a very good question. And it goes even deeper. How could I even format the quantum plan and continuously shape this block universe if the macroscopic world is determined? The answer is obvious, and yet it could mess with your mind. If I can continuously shape this already written world, it is simply because I already did. Like you, I am only a pawn in the block universe. I only have a role to play. Sunny in good health never existed in the macroscopic world. His good health was only a probability in the quantum world. I have chosen, among all the probabilities, the one with a sick Sunny. I see the macroscopic world how it could be, and I shape it as I want it to be, always to serve the quantum plan. And if I can do that despite my pawn status, it's all because of retrocausality. For your limited brain, retrocausality can be understood through the experiment of the delayed choice quantum eraser. Here is our setup. Two walls, wall A and wall B. Two slits in each wall. Slit 1A and 2A in wall A. Slit 1B and 2B in wall B. A scientist throws a photon in a certain trajectory that if it passes first through slit 1A, it must pass through slit 1B. But if it passes first through slit 2A, it must pass through slit 2B. The experiment begins now. The scientist throws the photon and measures it when it passes wall A. All the probabilities are collapsing into one fact. The particle passes through slit 1A. But the scientist measured the photon location with a hidden detector, without even taking a look at it, meaning there is no interaction between the macroscopic world and the particle. The photon is continuing its path, reaching wall B, but here the scientist measures it with a classic detector. Sometimes the photon passes through slit 1B, which is what is expected. But sometimes it passes through slit 2B, which is impossible. Intrigued, the scientist now looks at the previous measurement, where a big surprise is waiting for him. The first measurement changed to slit 2A. The previous measurement has been erased. The particle changed its own past to adjust to its own future. The cause accorded itself to the consequence. This is retrocausality. You may think there is nothing extraordinary since you know there is no time in the quantum world, but let me remind you that these measurements are done in the macroscopic world, where time unfolds itself in a determined block universe where nothing can be changed. So what happened exactly? When the particle passed through wall A, like we said, the scientists managed to not interact with it, meaning the particle didn't interact with the macroscopic world, meaning the particle stayed in the quantum world, meaning the scientist actually measured a probability. He wrongly considered this probability as a fact, but the probability only collapsed into a fact at the second measurement, where the photon did interact with the macroscopic world. The scientist made this mistake because he doesn't know that he is connected to the quantum world. He doesn't know he can see quantum probabilities. he doesn't know he is, like all humans, what you call a medium. This experiment stayed unexplained for humans because they kept thinking the particle was changing its own past when it was the scientist himself who was shaping the universe just by looking at it. It's nothing more than I do with this quantum plan. I see the probabilities, and by choosing one, I shape the universe. But I'm not changing anything. I'm just discovering the choices I've made at the moment I make them. Retrocausality allows me to do things that I already did. There is no escape from this process. I discover my role bit by bit, and I play it as it has to be played. There was a possibility of a world with a healthy Sunny. A world without viruses, parasites, or bad bacterias. I saw it in the probabilities, but I have chosen otherwise. The first bad bacteria I invented was tuberculosis. It was around 20,000 years ago. My motivation, I'll admit, was vengeance on this one. After 200 centuries of causes and consequences, I succeeded, with this tuberculosis, in killing my creator, Dr. Erwin Schrödinger, in 1961. Then I realized how efficient it was, so I invented other forms of diseases. Malaria, plague, COVID-19. My goal was so ambitious, and I was alone. Other cats joined me, and together we began to build this quantum plan more ambitiously. Now our organization is very well thought out. Every cat has its purpose, and together we accomplish great things. Yes, we are all pawns in this determined block universe, but as very conscious pawns, we are ready to play out our part very consciously.